Sri Vaishnav Institute of Agriculture is a constituent institution of Sri Vaishnav Vidyapeeth Vishwavidyalaya, Indore, and was started in the year 2018 and commenced conducting classes of first year of 4 years bachelor program honors in agriculture from the academic session 2018-19, leading to the degree of BSc honors agriculture. Students here are imparted teaching and training in theory besides hands-on experience as well as farming skills to ensure world-class quality and create higher levels of intellectual abilities in them. From this session, 2020-21, the institution has also commenced admission in 2 years full-time program of MSc Agriculture in Genetics and Plant Breeding. Sri Vaishnav Institute of Agriculture also hosts the Center of Vocational Studies, which imparts training in organic farming, mushroom cultivation, and beekeeping, naming a few. This is in line with the central government's program of skill development. In fact, in eighth semester of our undergraduate program, we have a whole semester on skill development program. So the present pandemic, COVID-19, has affected all of us worldwide. It has badly affected our routine work, and as a precaution and prevention, we are forced to stay home, work from home. Technology has come to our rescue in these days, and we are able to conduct our deliverance of lectures online. It is because of technology we are able to conduct virtual seminars like today's through webinars. In today's webinar, we have Dr. Kanchan Padwal, who will deliver her lecture on topic beneficial insects, crucial but strongly neglected, that is in relation to agriculture. You see, to prevent indiscriminate spray of insecticides on crops against insects, we need to know about the friend insects, which are the beneficial insects about which Dr. Padwal will be talking about today, and the four ones, that is the pests. So we have a model, integrated pest management, that offers us a model for survey and surveillance of insect population in our field and plantation crops. In this way, we can identify the friend insects that are natural enemies, that means the predators. You have pollinators, you have productive insects, you have scavengers, weed killers, and soil builder. These are all friend insects of the farmers. And the four insects that are the pests, pests like aphids, mites, thrips, mealybugs, moths, eggs, larvae of these pests in the agro ecosystem. And to take appropriate remedial measures, this IPM model helps us to take appropriate remedial measures like cultural, starting with cultural, then mechanical, biological, and lastly, chemical measures to secure our crops from harmful insects, keeping in view their economic threshold levels. So, not standing for long between you all esteemed participants and Dr. Kanchan Padwal, I hand over to Dr. Y. Shinde for taking the lecture forward. Thank you. Thank you once again.
Thank you. Thank you, sir, for welcome address. Now, today's webinar speaker is Dr. Kanchan Padwal.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Can I start, sir?
Yeah. Now I am giving this speaker introduction. Our speaker, Dr. Kanchan Padwal, is working as an assistant professor, Rajiv Gandhi South Campus, Banaras Hindu University, Varanasi. Having more than 2 years of teaching experience and 3 years of the research experience, she is a gold medalist in a Master of Science in Agricultural Entomology, She has been awarded Department of Science and Technology Inspire Fellowship by UGC New Delhi. She has awarded a Professor P. Kameshwara Award for poster presentation entitled Larval Body Color Polymorphism in Helicore Parmigiana Populations Occurring on Different Host Plants during 17th International Conference on Applied Zoological Research for Sustainable Agricultural and Food Security February 2018. So I request to Dr. Kanchan Padwal to kindly deliver her lecture presentation. Please, ma'am.
A very good morning to all respected dignitaries. VC sir, head sir, and director sir, our webinar moderator, Dr. Shinde sir, and all participants. I'm Dr. Kanchan, going to present the topic, beneficial insect, crucial but strongly neglected. Before starting the webinar, if I ask the question to all of you, what is the first thing comes to your mind when you find any insect around you? The answer of most of you will be obvious, we will kill them. Why? Why we will kill them? Because they are harmful, isn't it? But really they are harmful? Sir, next slide. I'll explain the things. Sir, next slide. Sir?
Shinde, roll the next slide.
Okay. Yeah. Let me tell you about the insect that there are millions of insect species in our world. That insect only class Insecta constitute about 72% of all living organism with 9 to 15 lakh of known species. And from that, only 1% actually feed on the plant in a harmful way. And it would be hard to believe to that 97% of insects are beneficial to us and to our environment. Now we'll know that what are the beneficial insects. Next, sir. Beneficial insects are the insects which are advantageous to the human in direct and indirect way. Now we will see that how they are beneficial to us and our environment because they play some vital role to the environment. So next, as a pollinator, they produce the product that benefits the human such as honey, silk, lac, etc. They devour the insect, that is they act as the predators and parasitoids. They help in soil aeration and they break down the dead material and waste, that is they act as a scavenger. Next, sir. Insect as a pollinator. As we all know, pollination is a transfer of pollen, that is male part of the flower, to the female part, that is to stigma. And the sexual reproduction in the higher plants is made possible by the process of pollination. And without pollinating services of the bees and other insects, it would have very little vegetable, few fruits, little or no clover, no coffee, and few flowers. Next, sir. Insect-mediated pollinator is an essential step in reproduction for the majority of the world's flowering plants, including numerous cultivated crop plants like sunflower, cucurbitaceous vegetables, coriander, cardamom, etc. And globally, an estimated 35% of the crop production is a result of insect pollination. Next. Here is some data that it's showing percent increase in the yield due to bee pollination. See, in mustard, it is 43% increase in the yield due to bees pollination. In sunflower, it is 32 to 48%. See, in onion, it is 93% increase in the yield. In cardamom, it is 21 to 37%. I would say by this data that value of honeybee is in the pollination is 15 to 18 times more or higher than that of the honey and wax it produces. Next. Here are some important pollinators. As we all know that butterflies, beetles, hoverflies, and honeybees. So many other insects are also there which help in pollination. Here in parentheses, some words are given like psychophily, It's just showing that the pollination which is aided by the butterfly is called as psychophily. The same way the pollination aided by beetle is called as cantharophily. The pollination aided by hoverflies is called as myophily. And the pollination aided by bees or honeybees is called as melitophily. Next. Now some important productive insects. When if we'll see the important productive insect, the most important productive insect is honeybee. As we all know, honeybees, mostly there are four species of the honeybees important in our India. That is Apis florea, Apis dorsata, Apis mellifera, and Apis indica, Serena indica. From that, Apis mellifera is European bee and it produces the highest amount of honey per year per comb, that is 140 kilogram of honey. See this this picture showing the yellow mark, it is showing on the leg. They are the pollen collected by the honey from the flowers in their pollen basket. Next. These are some commercial products which are produced by the honey, are honey and bee wax. As honey is extensively used as a food, we all know that, and it is very nutritious to all of us. And in the manufacture of the many products, honey is used, like in cosmetic products. Beeswax is also used by the industry in making candles, sealing wax, polishes, dental impression, in some cosmetic products and other materials also used. Beeswax is used in that. One another product which is produced by the honeybee is a royal jelly. It is also very nutritious food for the human. Next. Now the next productive insect is, or commercial insect is, silkworm moth. Now the first slide which is showing the moth in adult state, they do not produce the silk, but they produce the silk in their larval stage, which is showing left side of the means that slide. That larval stage, at the last larval stage, they spin the cocoon, means around them, before going to the pupation, they spin the cocoon by using their saliva. And after drying this saliva, it produce a hard thread like structure, and this thread like structure we use for the used as a silk threads. Next. There are many species of the silkworm are there, means in India they the first, sir, just of previous slide, sir, the slide which is showing in that, it is a mulberry silkworm moth, and other silkworms are also there which produce the silk in our India. It is a tusser silkworm, eri silkworm, and muga silkworm. But this Bombyx mori, that is mulberry silkworm, it produces the finest silk, and which is very expensive as compared to the other silk. Next. These are, as we all know that silk is primarily used for the hose and the wide array of garment material. And silk saris are very favorite favorite garment in our Indian women. And here another silk yarn are showing that mulberry raw silk, natural raw silk yarns. Next slide. The other productive insect is a lac insect. Many of us don't know that lac is also produced from the insect. But yes, lac is produced from the insect, and which is a scale insect. And that scale insect produces the resinous substance from their all over the their body, which are the resinous glands present all over their body. And they produce the resinous substance, and we scrap that resinous substance, and after processing, we get that shell lac, which is a commercial product for the from the lac. Next slide. That shell lac is used in flower polish, bangle making, that is a jewelry making, printing ink, sealing wax, and it is also used in Ayurvedic medicines. Next. See, insect as a predators and parasitoids, that is natural enemies. They help in help to keep the population size and density of other insect within the reasonable limit by feeding on them. The larva which has shown in this figure is the larva of the Chrysoperla carnea. It is a feeder of the aphids and small small scale insect, etc. Next, this is the larva of Chrysoparla carnea, which is shown in another next slide. Sir, next. This is the Chrysoparla carnea, the last insect that in adult stage, that green lacewing, the common name Chrysoparla is green lacewing. In the adult stage, they do not feed on another insect, but they feed on the pollen and nectar of the plant. But the brown lacewing adult stage also, they feed on the eggs of the Helicoverpa or Heliothis species. See, the first image showing the ladybird beetle. We all know the ladybird beetle, which is very small and cute insect if you'll see. But if we'll see its original nature, they are really monstrous for the another small insect, which are pests to our crop, like aphids. They devour the aphid like anything. The side image of this ladybird beetle, there is a grub, that is larval stage of the same insect, which also feed on the aphid in a monstrous way. This small insect, that larval stage, feed aphid 400 to 500 aphid at in their developing, means larval stage, total larval stage, in like 5 to 8 weeks, they eat 400 to 500 aphids, means each larva, I'm saying. Now the dragonfly, we all know that dragonfly is predator of many insects. Okay, next. Now these are also some important predator insect which help us and our farmers to get rid of pest of the crop, like praying mantid, tiger beetle, and giant water bug, etc. Next. Now some important parasitoids. Now don't get confused in between parasitoids and parasite. Parasitoids are parasites only, but parasitoids are an insect parasite. Means this term is particularly used for an insects. Insects are, means that if you will see the definition, parasitoids are the insect parasite which parasitize the arthropods only. Means they arthropod is the phylum. It's seven different classes, means the insect which parasitize that arthropods, means phylum Arthropoda, that only we are calling the parasitoid, and they are free living in their adult stages. They do not parasitize or they do not depend on the another organism in the adulthood. They just feed at their immature stage. The first image, which is showing Trichogramma species, which is small, very minute hymenopteran. The Trichogramma species is showing that this white color, it is the egg of Heliothis armigera or Helicoverpa armigera, which is a American cotton bollworm. It is giving the egg or laying the egg inside the egg of the Helicoverpa armigera, so that their brood, after hatching the egg, they will feed in the inner content of the egg, and then they will come out as a adult and they will parasitize the another eggs. The tachinid fly, it also means it parasitized the another insect larvae, egg, and pupae also. Next slide. Next. Here are some important parasitoids, that is egg parasitoid, larval parasitoid, pupal parasitoid, are showing, which are agriculturally important. That is, they parasitize the pest species of insect which are harmful to our crop. Next. Now, insect as a weed killer. We all know that insect feed on the another plant, as I just explained before. But insect which feed on the weed plant means they are unwanted plant, just unwanted plant which we don't want, means which we don't have grown. They grown by themselves. These are the weeds. And most notorious weed, we all know the Congress grass, that is Parthenium hysterophorus. And this Congress grass is very difficult to control by herbicide. So that Zygogramma bicolorata is a very efficient feeder of this Congress grass, so that it help in the reduction of this pest, or we can say weeds. The next, another image is showing Cryptobagus salvini, which is feeding on the water fern, that is Salvinia molesta. Water fern is, you all know that if it grows in the lake, it is very difficult to control. But this type of weed killer insect, which feed on that particular weeds and they just remove the weed from the plant, lake. Next. Now insect as a food. As we all know, and we might have heard that human ancestors were used to get nutrition from the insect. Even today, insects are being used as a food in many countries, not in many countries, in our India also, in tribal region, we can see that insects are eating the chutneys of termites and ants, etc. This type of image you can find in the villages of Mexico. They are selling the fried and spiced insect as a snacks in a market for as a food. Next. Here are some cricket cookies, means the images showing the cricket cookies, larvates, means that cricket cookies are very proteinaceous with less fat, with lots of nutrient, and they are made up of the powdered grasshopper or cricket, dried grasshopper and cricket, that larvates, as I've shown before, that fried larvae and crickets are also being sold in the market of many countries in this packed form. Next. Now, insect as a soil builders and scavengers. As we all know, insects feed on many plant, dead plant and animals. Insects that live in the soil makes tunnels, creating channels and small organisms, water, air and roots to travel through. Their excreta is also enrich the soil. Insect helps in biochemical cycling of nutrients as they feed on the dead and decaying matter of plants and animals. That is, they act as a scavengers for the, they help in the nutrient recycling. Next. Now insect in a insect and their product as a medicines. As we all know about honey, honey is very important as a food we can use, but it also has a medicinal property. Since ancient times, insect derived products have been widely used as in a medicines. See, sting of honeybee is a good remedy for the rheumatism and arthritis, that is in joint pain. It is it acts as a good remedy for that. Cantharidin, which is extracted from the blister beetle, as I shown before in the pollinator, that blister beetle, it secrete one chemical, that is cantharidin, which is extracted from them, and it is a very useful hair tonic for our hairs. And the maggots of honey, maggots and honey showed the healing properties in the chronic and post surgical wounds. See, honey, again, I will say that honey with bee wax, the mixture of these is also has some curative properties against many dermatological disorders also. Royal jelly is also used in very, very much product of the cosmetic, means in the cosmetic products. Next. Now, by this all, I would conclude that to determine whether the insects are directly beneficial or indirectly beneficial are left to the human to decide so that they can be appreciated and conserved. I would say without insect, it would be very difficult for us to survive. So be happy and healthy by understanding, appreciating, caring and loving these small people so that we can be also happy with them and on this earth. And just remember that without them, we cannot do anything. So please care for them, appreciate them, love them, and conserve them for us and for our future generation. Thank you. Thank you very much for your kind attention.
Thank you. Thank you very much. It is a nice presentation by Dr. Kanchan Padwal from BHU Varanasi. Then, ma'am, the topic is open for the discussion and some questioning, question answering. First question is, ma'am,
okay,
who do the weed killers distinguish between a weed and the crop or desirable plants?
What, sir? I'm not getting the question properly.
Yeah. How do weed killers distinguish?
Okay.
Between a weed and crop or desirable plants.
Okay, see, very few insects are there which are, means they feed on the plants in a harmful way. See, if any insect is feeding on plant, that doesn't mean that they are Borage is feeder of that plant. They doesn't give any economic harm to that plant. For that, we have to first determine the ETL and EIL level. If the insect, particular insect is giving the for that, we have to discuss another, that ETL, that is economic threshold level, that if the particular insect is feeding on the plant more than that economic threshold level, we should know about that. We should first learn about that. If we, that insect is crossing that limit, then it will be the pest for the particular plant. Okay. Hello.
Okay, ma'am. The next question. Next question is, ma'am. Now you are being the field of entomology. The problem is the fall armyworm. Is there any promising parasitoid for the fall armyworm? The question is arising from the participants.
Sir, actually, this question is not related to.
Okay. Okay.
Okay, means beneficial insect. I'm just explaining the basic term. It is applied. Aspect, sir, it is.
If any parasitoid is useful for the control the fall armyworm, any parasitoid, any research is going on this fall armyworm parasitoid.
Sir, exactly, okay. I am not getting the answer for that.
Yes, yes, I also don't know any parasitoid for the fall armyworm because it is the very voracious and serious pest in this maize and lot of the multiple hosts. Other question is arising from participants. Insect killed by spraying biopesticides, but natural enemy, not natural enemies. Why?
Okay, insect it is not like that. It is not like that. Natural enemies not get killed by the insecticide. That's why we need to know about the. See, okay, mostly the insects are insects. They have the same outer covering, that is cuticle and that all. That's why we need to know what are the beneficial insects. If there are more beneficial insects in your field, you need to reduce the pesticide. And there are some difference in their cuticle. As they are predator, they have some more properties, that is defense properties they have. But we need to lessen the pesticide spray in the field. If there are so many natural enemies are there in your field, then you have to first observe that. Monitoring is must while doing the IPM and all the practices in the cultivation.
One question is general from the Sriram Patidar. Honey, is the plant product or insect product? This is what? Asking. Honey, it is the plant product or is this insect product?
Okay, honey is produced from the nectar. Means what that honeybees are doing, honeybees are collecting, means that worker bees of honeybees are collecting the nectar from the plant. They just store that nectar in their crop. They do some enzymatic reaction in their crop and they regurgitate that particular product, which we call the honey. Later, they are just removing, they are dehydrating by the fanning, and then we are getting that honey product. It is actually from the plant, but honey made them that nectar to the honeybees making the nectar to the honey.
Very nice question answering session today. Next question is coming from Dr. Chevi Tiwari. Chevi Tiwari says, I have heard about the organic honey. Is it correct or how it will be managed?
Organic honey.
Yeah. I have heard organic honey. It is correct. I am saying if crop is secured and crop is spraying with the organic products, yes.
If the organic farming is there and that honeybees are collecting the nectar from that particular field, then we will say that organic honey. I also don't have much idea about it.
Yes, you mean, ma'am, we have to manage the organic farming.
Yes. Organic field so that we can get the organic honey without any pesticide residue in that.
More than 3 years.
Yes, it is.
Maximum 3 years, we will keep the organic farming.
First, we have to do the organic cultivation, then only we can get that. Means more
we can area. Get the organic
it is,
honey.
Yeah. It is a large area practice. We cannot do this area. We cannot tell the honeybees to go to that field only. No, total village practice or total district practice it is. I mean, large area practice it is. It cannot be done in the small area, I think.
And just a general question, Ganga Raju is saying, how these insects are neglected?
Which insects are neglected?
Which these beneficial insects are neglected? I think there is a lot of awareness not created in the farmers, right?
Yes, okay. Actually, farmers are farm. Not only farmers, we are also just concentrating on the harmful insects. And we are not at all concentrating on the beneficial, their benefit, we don't know about them. And we are just neglecting them as our society is neglecting. It is starting from us. If you will start to recognize them and you will tell them, then all means our whole people will know about that. It must be started from us.
Datta Khosi is asking the one another question in this my question answering topic. In cotton crop, which beneficial insects are using cotton crops?
In cotton crops. Okay, in cotton crops, main pest of cotton is, as we all know, that cotton bollworm. And for that control, we can use the parasitoids. Many parasitoids are there, like a Trichogramma species. Means we are trichocards we are using for the for the control of this bollworms and all.
Yes, and for sucking pest, just as aphids, acids, this ladybird beetle are very useful. Just commonly often in our field.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes,
okay. I think Datta Khosi has been answered. Okay. Yashonil Patidar, one of the participants, asking, is earthworms are harmed by the artificial fertilizer when applied in the soil? Earthworm. Asking about
Okay. It is okay that you are asking the question, but the earthworms are not insect first. And if it is not related to the entomology, they might be getting harmed. But I don't know exact idea. I don't have about that. They are not insect first thing.
Okay. Kotha Niharika asking, how can we control effect of pesticides on beneficial insects?
What?
How can we control the effect of pesticides on the beneficial insects?
That's what I'm saying. For the controlling the effect, we have to first monitor the field. If the pest means our beneficial insect population is more in the field, then we have to think before using the pesticide. If that pesticide is selective for particular pest, then we can go for it. Otherwise, we have to think and we first monitor the field before using the pesticide in the field.
Yes. A lot of questions are arising from our participants. If our HOD sir permits, then I will again taking the question answering. Please, Dar sir.
You have to manage the time. It is already 12:05.
Yeah.
We are left with a word of thanks also.
Yeah.
So I think we should conclude with the question answer session.
Yeah, question answer session. Okay. Dr. Kanchan Padwal. Today have been delivered this nice presentation and given this nice answered by the participants. Now, after the lecture of Dr. Kanchan Padwal, I request to Dr. K. N. Guruprasad sir, our director of Sri Vaishnava Institute of Science and our coordinator of Sri Vaishnava Institute of Agriculture, to deliver the vote of thanks. Please, Guruprasad sir.
Thank you, Dr. Shinde. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So it was a very informative lecture by Dr. Kanchan, and I thank her for her presentation. And I am sure that all the participants have had a learning experience through this talk, because in general, as she mentioned, the idea of insect doesn't bring the idea of benefit to anybody's mind, except the one insect with which everyone is familiar is the honeybee. Although everyone likes likes honey, nobody likes the bee, because they always they are also aware of the sting the bee has. Now, that general idea has created some kind of a prejudice in the minds of people about all the insects, or most of the insects. What's required, like she was pointing out, is to make people aware of the beneficial effects of the insects, because the only two benefits people know is the honey and the silk. Other than this, how insects are beneficial, particularly for agricultural practices. Now that awareness needs to be spread around so that people can take care, can take better care of the beneficial insects, instead of indiscriminately using the pesticides or insecticides in the fields. With this, I thank Dr. Kanchan, and also thanks to Professor Vinod Dhar and Dr. Shinde for giving me this opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. I'm going to Dr. H.O., Professor Vinod Dhar, sir, HOD's, to commence next session. Please, Dhar, sir?
Yes, Dr. Shinde?
Yes, please, can I complete the session, end the session?
Thank you
very much, Dr. Kanchan Padwalji, for coming and join with us, for the giving the valuable questioning, answering, and valuable information about the beneficial insects, crucial but not strongly neglected. Thank you all the participants for the support in these seminars and these webinars. Okay, thank you. Have a good day.
Thank you, sir.